Hello everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to get started with the Syncfusion Image Editor for Xamarin Forms. This tutorial will help you understand how easy it is to add an image to the image editor and edit that image with our predefined toolbar items. In this tutorial, I'll be using Visual Studio 2017 with Xamarin already installed in it. I will show you how to create a demo application in Xamarin Forms, Android, iOS, and UWP. To get started, let's first open Visual Studio. I'll then create a new project. Choose cross-platform, and then mobile application for Xamarin Forms. I'll name this application Getting Started, and then click OK. Now I'll be prompted to choose our platforms and code sharing strategy. For this project, I'll leave all of the platforms selected and use the .NET standard code sharing strategy. I'll also be creating a blank app, which is already chosen as the default. Next, I'll click OK and wait for Visual Studio to set up our project. While that's happening, let's go through the features of the built-in toolbar in the Syncfusion Image Editor. The tool is preloaded with pretty much all the features of the image editor. You can draw over images using the pen tool. You can annotate images with shapes, including rectangles, circles, and arrows. You can also add text, crop, rotate, and even flip images. Okay, now that the project is ready, the first thing we have to do is add the required assemblies for the image editor from the NuGet package manager. As you can see, we have four different projects in the solution, one for Android, iOS, UWP, and also one for code sharing. Now I'll right-click on the solution and choose Manage NuGet Packages for Solution. On this next screen, choose the Browse tab, and then search for Syncfusion Xamarin SF Image Editor. Now select the SF Image Editor package for Xamarin Forms, and then choose the project it needs to be installed on. In this case, it is all the projects. And then click Install. Make sure to read and accept all of the license agreements. And then continue installing. So now the projects are ready. I'll start with Android as our startup project. So let's begin by just running the Android project to see what we're starting with. Here we have the default application running and showing Welcome to Xamarin Forms. All right, so now we're ready to add the Syncfusion Image Editor to the project. I'll start by opening up the mainpage.xaml file from the Getting Started shared project. To add the image editor to the page, we need to add the class reference to the XAML file. At the top, add xmlns:syncfusion. And then choose the namespace Syncfusion Image Editor. Now I'll add a tag for the Syncfusion Image Editor to the page, and I'll do this by referencing that namespace we just created. And that's it. Now we need to add an image to the editor so we can edit it. To do this, I'm going to add an image to the shared project by right-clicking on it and adding an existing item. Now that the image has been added, I need to set it as an embedded resource. To do this, right-click on the image, and then select Properties, and then change the build action to Embedded Resource, and click OK. Now we can set the image as a source to the image editor. First, I'll add a name to the image editor in the XAML. And I'll just call it Image Editor, IMG Editor. Now we can open the code behind for the mainpage.xaml file. And here, we can reference the image editor we just named and set its source property. So I'll type in ImageEditor.source equals image source from resource, and then I'll type in our project name dot our image file name. And that's it. So now let's build and deploy this project again and see it in our Android emulator. Now you can see that the image editor is loaded with the image that we chose. So we can now edit the image with all the provided tools. So everything works as expected with our custom selected image. Now let's deploy the same project on iOS. To do this, I'll set our iOS project as a startup project, just as we did before. Since I'm using a Windows machine, I previously configured my Visual Studio to connect to a Mac on my network. This is required to deploy to iOS. Additionally, Xamarin does not load the renderer assemblies by default in a Xamarin.Forms.iOS project. In order to solve this, you must manually create an instance of the SF Image Editor renderer in the FinishLoadingOverloaded method of the AppDelegate class in the iOS project. So, to do this, all I need to do is expand the iOS project and then open the AppDelegate class file. And inside the finished launching method, I'm going to create an instance of the editor renderer. The exact instructions and code you need to insert here can also be found in our documentation. So you could also just copy and paste that from our documentation on the image editor. So I'm typing in syncfusion.imageEditor.xForms.iOS.sfImageEditorRenderer.init. Now I'll choose the iPhone simulator and click Run. I'm using the iPhone X simulator, and you can see that part of the control is actually obscured by the notch. We can fix this by using the UseSafeArea property. In the mainpage.xaml file, we need to add a new namespace to be able to use some Xamarin-specific iOS code. So I'll type in xmlns:iOS=, and then iOS again and choose the iOS specific namespace. Now we can use that new iOS namespace where we referenced to access the UseSafeArea property and set it to true. And now we can run the iOS simulator again to see the changes. All right, this time we can see that the app is correctly rendered on the iPhone X and all of our image editing tools are of course available. So everything works as it did before on iOS. Next, let's run the project in UWP to make sure that our Xamarin app is fully cross-platform capable. So I'll set the UWP project as my startup project again, and then I'll deploy it to the local machine in order to see it. All right, and once again, we can see that we have the exact same experience and layout in our UWP project as we did in Android and iOS. So same feature set, and everything works as expected, as it should in a Xamarin Forms application. So we have three different projects from one single bit of shared code, and that was it. So to recap, in this video, we showed you how to start a new Xamarin Forms project, add the Syncfusion image editor to it, then also add an image to be edited. We also tested the features of the image editor in Android, iOS, and UWP. We hope you found this video helpful, and please feel free to check out our other great content.